Basically, my Pampered Chef journey began about 12 years ago. I was this single 25-year-old TV producer living in my first big girl apartment in Brooklyn, and I just started getting into cooking. I was invited to my first Pampered Chef party by a high school friend, and I had no clue what I was getting myself into. I was just kind of excited for the free food and drinks. I immediately fell in love with everything that I saw, and I had to have it all. After talking to the consultant, I decided to sign up for the new consulting kit because, according to her, all I needed to do was 4 parties and I can keep all these amazing products. Well, that's easy, I thought. My mom can host, my sister, my aunt, and my cousin, and then I'll just be done with this business. I mean, I already had a great full-time career as a TV and radio producer, so I really didn't need another job. At my first party for my sister, her neighbor quickly said, "I want to have a party." And I'm thinking to myself, but I didn't even ask her. It wasn't so bad though, because for a few hours of fun, I got paid. And I figured I'd do a few more parties than I planned. And I kind of really was starting to enjoy all the freebies I was earning. So I happily did the neighbor's party a few weeks later, and there I got 2 more bookings. Wow, this is pretty easy, I thought. So I did Pampered Chef for about 1.5 years then. I put little effort into my business and made nice little paychecks, but then I called it quits when my freelance producing job would get me spontaneous work and I wasn't able to make the commitments to parties. You see, back then, we didn't have social media to help with our business, so it was primarily just doing in-home shows. I did really enjoy being a consultant, and I always thought in the back of my head, this would be a great job for me one day if I had a family with a bunch of kids. So now let's fast forward to 2005. I married the love of my life, Brian, a New York City police officer. I was working as a personal PR assistant to real estate mogul Barbara Corcoran. We bought a house and we were ready to fill the room with babies. After trying to get pregnant for over 1 year, I discovered I had polycystic ovarian syndrome. I was going to need assistance from a fertility doctor to get pregnant. We started right away with costly hormone treatments that were not only draining on my body, but also our savings account. Money didn't matter, we just wanted a family. So we used some of our savings and even credit cards to pay off these doctors and labs. After 2 years of treatment, our miracle Brandon was born. In August of 2007, I was so happy to finally be a mom, and even thought, even though it was going to be hard, Brian agreed I was going to leave my city job and be a full-time mom to this precious angel. Brian worked security jobs on the weekends, and I even took a few shifts at a restaurant waitressing for extra money. We knew we wanted more children, so we started the IVF process again once Brandon turned 1 year old. We weren't sure how long it was going to take to get pregnant again, but we were quickly blessed with the news that I was carrying twins. Wow, what a blessing. But we were terrified because that was 3 babies in diapers, 3 mouths to feed. But Brian kept assuring me he would do whatever it took to make it work so I could raise our family. So my twins, Christian and Carissa, were born in April of 2009. It was really hard having 2 newborns and a 20-month-old, and I barely left my house. I was home alone most of the time, changing diapers and running on no sleep. Brian worked as much overtime as possible and took on extra jobs. He was never around, and he wasn't getting to enjoy these babies and was starting to resent me, especially when I would complain the minute he walked in the door after a long day. The fighting started and the bills piled up. 2 years went by, our savings account was empty, our credit cards were full, and we knew something had to change. Knowing that daycare for 3 small children would probably cost as much as our mortgage, it did not pay for me to go back to a city job, and Brian suggested going back to waitressing nights when he got home from work. When would I sleep, I thought. It's bad enough I barely sleep now with 3 little ones. Then, in July of 2012, I received an invitation that would change my life. My friend Deandra was having a Pampered Chef party, and I was so excited because my son recently broke my egg slicer plus, and I needed a new one. But then I started thinking about the business opportunity. I told Brian my idea, and he thought I was nuts. I could hear his I knew the potential of this business if I put more effort, and I had nothing to lose if I just gave it a try again. So I went to the party, and I was super excited to be with Nancy Junker. I was in awe of her blinked-out apron, and I knew I needed one just like it, of course. She had us laughing the entire time, and I could not wait to work with her. If I remember correctly, I said, I'm going to be your easiest recruit ever. I was excited to learn that even though the company was now owned by Warren Buffett, they still held the consultants as the backbone of this business. And even when someone placed a random order online, a consultant was still getting commission. I went home so excited, and I told Brian I was giving the Pampered Chef a try again. And if it didn't work out, I was going to get that waitressing job. In my very first month, I did four parties and brought home a $1,000 check. And said, what are you doing, stripping at these parties? You keep selling those spatulas, babe. And now, he gladly carries out my bags to the car every time I have a party. In a year's time, I have built a team of over 30. I'm promoted to advanced director, earned the trip to Punta Cana, and my paychecks have more than doubled. I am still a full-time mom, and I don't miss a moment with these precious miracles. I am so, so grateful to this amazing company for giving me the opportunity to achieve the perfect life balance. Nancy Junker, I'm so glad you asked.
This incredible business, oh my goodness, stop, that we call direct selling for 28 years. And it's always good to be reminded what it is we offer people and how we can give them something that they could never have. I just can't imagine what your life would be like today if you hadn't found the Pampered Chef. It's just an amazing story. You're an amazing leader. And Caryn, I want you to know that I really believe the Pampered Chef is blessed to have you, as well as your blessing.